understands, and he never misunderstands. Amen. He knows right where we're coming from. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Anybody ever run on empty? I have. More times than you can count. More times. I just need a dose of Jesus every day. How about
Amen.
You? Every single day. He is the air we breathe. He's everything. He's awesome. I need him more today than I ever have. Ever have. I need him more. I don't ever quit needing Jesus, do we? So good. So good.
Amen. You know, a lot of times in my life, I've been on empty. Well, it's worse than being on empty in your gas tank there on the interstate somewhere and there ain't no gas station, man. I mean, it's bad. When you get on empty sometimes and it seems that your spirit, man, gets down to the bottom, just bottomed out, and you don't know what you want to do. And you go to hunt friends to try to encourage you, and they don't have what's going to get you back where you need to be. And we get so empty sometimes, man, it feels like life is hopeless, it's useless, that nothing's going to work, nothing's going to ever be good for you anymore. And until you get back in relationship with the Lord, your life will go on that way. But I found that when I'm in relationship with Him, Miriam, I'm full. My tank is full and everything is good. And I'm glad of that today. I'm glad that when I get down, He picks me up. I'm glad that when I walk into a dark place, He lights the place to put my feet. I'm so glad that He loves us today. I'm glad that when the cupboards are empty, He can fill them. When the billfolds, you ain't got a dollar bill in it, man, He can help you to get by. Amen. Thank God for that. Let's give Him a hand clap. I'll ask you if you'll stand up for a few minutes and let's just give our heart to God totally.
I had a bad day, I had a sad day, and now I'm going just right.
I don't care if it's a headache. I don't care if it's diabetes. I don't care if it's cancer. My God is a healing God, and He's here to heal. I tell you, He's here to touch you this morning. But you've got to desire it. You've got to want Him, not just His gifts. Can we get beyond the gifts for just a second? And let's just want God. Let's just fall in love with Him. And when we're in love with Him, His gifts come. When we're praising Him, when we're lifting Him up, that's when the giftings come. Now we're getting ready to have a change in the service right now. God's a healing God. I want to see your hands up this morning. If you believe God is a healing God, now I need to get past one other little barrier right here. Do you believe God is going to heal? Not He can, but He is going to heal. You got to believe He is the healer. He is the healer. If you believe He's saved you, if you trust in that, believe that He is the healer and is going to heal you. Do you believe that? All right. David, did you come up here? Willie, did you come up here? Amen. Glory to God. Ooh, yeah. Brother Rick, you come right on. Brother, do you need a touch this morning, David? Do you need a touch this morning? You need a touch from God. Give me another chair. Oh, I believe God's a healer. I believe God can do anything. Oh, hallelujah. He's good.
Yeah.
Willie.
has been such a turnaround in my sister's life.
Amen.
We've been praying for her, and she's been hungry for God. And our family, you know, aunt, uncle, cousins, we all get together, you know, usually once a week for a Bible study. And she's been hungry for God, wants to read her word more, listen to, she's going to be here this morning, but she couldn't be. But anyway, God's doing such a wonderful work that she's, her heart is really turned to God.
Amen.
And another request that we prayed for, the guy who was in the hospital with kidney failure. His kidney started working a week ago. And he's coming home Tuesday, and the doctor said, I'll be honest, he said, I never thought you would come off dialysis. And God miraculously healed him. My dad, he's a veteran, and he's been having a problem. He had a stent in his heart, and his oxygen would drop real low. He had a stent back in, I guess, January, and he started cardio rehab last week, and his oxygen's been staying normal. His blood sugar's been a lot better. I mean, just so God just doing a great, mighty work.
Awesome.
The prayers that I prayed for the Pennsylvania trip, God done some amazing work. You know, just amazing to see what God is done and is doing up there. So.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
So, Father, we just thank you, Lord, that today may not be in the typical service, but you know, you're not a typical God. Jesus, you didn't have a typical agenda or a typical schedule. You were just led by the Holy Spirit. And it says, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and power, who went about doing good and healing all that was oppressed of the devil. So that's what ought to happen, God, when we gather in your name, because you said we gather in your name, you're in our midst. So therefore, God, healing of sickness and oppression of the enemy should happen every time we gather. So we thank you, Lord, that your word was manifest today. It was brought forth in action, and that which you have begun, Father, you will perform it and you will finish it. You are the author and the finisher of all of our faith. We thank you, Lord, that as we go forth as lights into a dark world. We thank you, Lord, for mighty miracles and testimonies, God, in our everyday lives as we go forth. In Jesus' name.